Welcome to Massive Beers. My name is Matt. We do the beer stuff here. Side by side. It's been a hot minute since we've done a side by side. I mean, if you count like the mix packs that I've been doing, that's technically a side by side. But it's more of a side by side, traditional like in the form of Treehouse. Getting some greens up in his piece, people. Yeah. Very green, which I've reviewed before. It's been several years. Versus the greenest of greens. Yeah. My buddy George, Massive Troll Reviews, you all know him, you all love him. He passed through Treehouse and thought of me. Thank you very much, George. Very appreciative, because it's been a minute since I've reviewed anything. Treehouse, let's dive into it. So yeah, very green. It's double IPA, 0.3%. It says here, very green is an original Treehouse double IPA crafted with carefully selected blend of Australian and American hops. It pours with a dense yellow body in the glass and forms a thick meringue-like head. It opens in the glass with huge notes of ripe pineapple, pithy citrus, and dank saturated hops. As it warms, it shows its depth and complexity. Sweet bits of malt intermingle with the straight Tropicana juice. It has a soft but prominent bitterness and a rich, velvety mouthfeel. This is the very best beer we can offer you. Enjoy. This has a can on date of 22 days ago. It's from August 1st. Of 2023. Yeah. As far as the greenest of greens, this being 8.8% alcohol by volume, double IPA. I gotta remove my glasses because it's hard to read. The greenest of greens is our latest endeavor and to push the envelope of the green to new heights. Featuring layered hop approach and drawing from lessons learned from our Find the Limit series, the greenest green is ridiculously hop saturated yet flavorful on a palate. Pouring a milky yellow color in a glass, it hits your senses with a true wow factor with overwhelming notes of pineapple and tropical fruit. Finishing with a sharp but short-lived bitterness, it retains beautiful balance in spite of hop onslaught it brings. At 10 years, we remain invigorated and inspired with what the future holds for Treehouse. This project has brought us so much joy. Your trust and support has given us the opportunity, and we're grateful, eternally grateful for that. Yeah. Likewise, it is Treehouse. Looks like there's something cryptic in the background here that I can't really make out. No. It's just it's their patio in the background, I believe. You're not going to be able to see it on camera. It's ultra faint behind the logo. So, you know, it's a classic Treehouse logo. One's, you know, a little riff on just green. This one's a little bit more stylish, but, you know, pretty much the same. Yeah. They must, and you can tell they must make this one much more often because this is a printed on can, whereas it's a sticker label. So I assume this is just a, you know, less of a run of a beer. Anyway, I always dig their labels. I think they're good, you know. They're very much the same over and over. Once you dive into kind of, you know, Curiosity Theories and a couple of their other beers, more traditional beers, they tend to be a little bit more artistic. But I can dig having that variance. So let's give this a pour and see what's what. You're talking about 8.3 versus, what, 8.8 was it? Yes. So yeah. Not too far off on each other's thing, so let's give that the rotation. Put it like that. They look markedly very much the same. And, you know, it is, you know, just a rich, thick, turbid kind of haze. This one probably looks a skosh darker to you. There's less liquid in that glass, so it has a little bit of light, more light going through it. From my perspective, it's very much the same. Maybe this side has a little bit kind of milkiness to it. That's probably me talking myself into it. No, let's level it out. We don't have to not pour the rest in there to make it even. Yeah, we don't have to do that. So, yeah, they're the same. For all intents and purposes, they're the same. You know, both about the same head. This one's quite a bit bigger just because I poured a little extra in there. Just off-white, creamy edge. Actually, this one's leaving a little bit of lacing already. You know, it looks like part of a big old turbid hazy. Let's dive into some very green. That is green. I didn't give you a date on this one. This one is actually a little bit older. You know, just by a couple days. This is can on the 27th of July. So, shouldn't be that big of a difference. Yeah. Just, you know, what do they say? Don't put the word that you're trying to describe in the definition. Isn't that like a rule when it comes to like spelling bees? It smells very green. You know what I mean? That's what it comes off as. So it comes off of this green hop peltiness. Tropical fruit with this just green, little weedy dankiness. a sweetness to it, a perceptional sweetness that it's going to be a nice sweet beer. Done and done. It really is that kind of on the nose. I'm not just saying that just to be as generic as possible. It's really how it does come off for me. Sweet tropical fruitiness, a bit of sweetness, perception of sweetness. Again, I have to say that, otherwise people flip out. And then, you know, just this nice kind of slightly weedy kind of greeniness. The greenest of greens. Is there a difference? At least on the nose. This one just, honestly, smells very, very same. This one probably has just a perception of sweetness thing that is maybe a micron more and maybe a little less hop green impact. Maybe that extra couple days does that. Very, very similar on the nose. Not really getting a big variance on these two. Doesn't make for a negative thing. But it's just that little touch of more freshness over here with that little bit of this perceptional sweetness and that greeny kind of dankiness. So let's dive in. Cheers, y'all. Just diving right in. Let's go back the other way. Honestly, it's the Pam photo. Corporate wants to know the difference. It's really the same beer. Honestly, for me, it's very, very, very similar. It could be as much as that, honestly, and I'm not joking. I'm not trying to be like, oh, wheat makes a big difference. It could be the wheat that made this just a little bit closer to this. But if that's the case, lush mouthfeel. Doesn't come off super fluffy, but it has this nice kind of richness to it. Nice density to it that's a little bit heftier than something that's super, super soft. It's just not overly sweet. I thought it was going to be a little bit sweeter than what the nose... I thought it was going to be sweeter because of what the nose led me to believe. But actually, the combination of how aggressive the hops are, which they are just this very aggressive greeniness, both hop pellet green and a little bit of weedy green, kind of knocks down that sweetness, makes it a little bit less sweet. Probably a little bit undersweet for me, honestly. And you're talking to a person that if I'm going to prefer something to be undersweet than oversweet, this one I just want a little bit more, just a touch more sweetness on it. But that mouthfeel and that density makes you think you're drinking a big beer. It's still drinkable, but it has its heft to it. And that bit of tropical fruit, almost like overripe tropical fruit, where it's like the sweetness has kind of gone away a little bit, and it's kind of almost like the fruit is fermenting a little bit, and it kind of has that vibe going for it. And it really is just that, just copious amounts of hops that are giving you both a green weediness on top of a big, big, big green pop palatiness. Again, no hop burn. I'm not getting a hop burn on the palate, but it smells like hops, hop pellets. It tastes like hops pellets smell. Let's put it that way. Now, on this side of things, it is very, very much the same, honestly. I mean, at this point, me trying to pull out differences in these two, I think is me trying to pull out differences in these without them actually existing. But I'm going to do it. It's called science. Not really. Mouthfeel over here, I think it is a little bit more fluffy, just a touch, a skosh. I think maybe the hops are just a micron less than over here. And that could just be me starting off on this side and going to this side. It could be. But if anything, it's just a hair less. And what that does is it lets that sweetness come. I mean, we're talking percentage points here, not one, you know, out of 1 out of 10, an extra point, like 0.01% or something like that. It has just this little perceptual sweetness thing that's just a skosh hair more. Yeah. I mean, honestly, that's pretty much it. Both of these have really lush. Not ultra fluffy, but a bit denser mouthfeel. You know you're drinking something big, double IPA-ish. The sweetness here is a little bit less than I would assume it would be. In a perfect world, maybe a hair less than I want it to be. And then that hop assault on both ends of the spectrum is all the green arbol on us with that danky weediness and big hop peltiness. That's it. They're okay. Like, I'm not going to sit here and go gaga over these two. You know, it really is. They're very, very simple beers. They're giving you that mouthfeel in combination with a slight undersweetness. Again, the tropical fruit that is either, if you want to call it, an underripened tropical fruit or an overripened, starting to lose its sweetness because it's fermenting kind of tropical fruit. And that makes sense to you. Hopefully it does, because that's how it does come off to me. And they're very tasty beers. Are they some of the better double IPAs I've had of late? Absolutely. Are they Mount Rushmore? That's not even close, to be honest with you. And maybe it's the combination of them, both of them being very, very, very similar beers. But, I'm a guy who yammers into the camera. You know, I have no, you know, whatever you want to call it. I was going to say qualifications. That's not a good way to put it. I'm not going to sit here and say that, and what I say is that, no, be all. Actually, I will say that. I'm arrogant enough. No, I'm joking. Maybe I am. Anyway, but honestly, they're very similar. They're very similar to a point where I think if I drank these blind, not only would I think they're the same beer, but if I drank them blind and then I mixed them up, I wouldn't know it. You know, I don't think there's really much difference, variance between these two other than the cans they come in. And is that a negative thing? I guess if you're looking in variance, but you're also talking about a base of a beer that they're tweaking and messing with. This is not just a distant cousin of green. This is very much in the same core lineage of green. So it's kind of gonna be the same beer. So I'm not gonna sit here and say, how dare they put the very similar beers in two different cans. This is literally, one's called the Greenest Green, the other one's called Very Green. It's like you're splitting hairs here. It's a sunroof on a car as opposed to a moonroof. You know what I mean? Like, it's the same car, just have different options. But they're so close to where I'm like, you know, side by side, I think you detect that. If you drink them over the course of a couple different beers overnight or even a couple days apart, maybe you don't detect it all that much. But for me, very, very similar. So whichever one's cheaper, buy that one. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, yeah, I don't know so what I'm going to say other than they're very tasty, well done, very green forward beers. Again, we're getting on this roller coaster ride. It's going to go up now. We know that because it's called green. We want the green, so we're getting the green. Thumbs up there. Just in a perfect world, I would like just a skosh more sweetness here. And maybe just kind of liven that mouthfeel up. Maybe a little bit more fluffy, you know. Maybe a little bit more creamy and not as dense. I think that would open up a bit of that sweetness and just make a little bit better of beer. But at the same time, they're very tasty beers. They're great double IPAs. I'm glad I had them. But as far as personally myself, being Mount Rushmore status, just kind of falls short of that. So there you go. Like I said, some of the better ones, yes. Mount Rushmore, no. Valiant Availability, don't know. People, let me know and leave you with, if you like, well, we like these. If you like big grain beers and hazies and all that fun stuff, you'll dig these. They're delicious. They're tasty. I'm just not going berserker over them. That's just me. Treehouse, have you been to the breweries? Any of their 47 breweries they have now? Have you been to Charlton or Muntinson? Where are they in? It's Charlton now. Have you been in that brewery? I've been there a couple times. Have you had these beers? Have you had these batches? 727, 8, 1 of these two. Have you had them? What are your thoughts? Are they very similar? Are they very not similar? Are they very green? Or are the greenest of the greens? I don't know. I want you to tell me down there. What's your favorite Treehouse beer, too? That'd be nice. There you go. Reviewing the books. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the review. Hopefully I'm drawing a little bit of Treehouse right now. We'll see you next time. Oh, Coovy. I don't know why we have to do it. I always forget, but cheers. It tastes the same. Hopefully you enjoyed the review. Hope we'll see you next time. Cheers, y'all.